UIU file 0041. Altered high school building in. Confirmed anomaly 3. Object class 53. Highly intrusive, unknown capabilities, unknown nature. Secure containment protocols. The following text has been struck through. Confirmed anomaly 3, CA3, is to be surrounded by an electric fence no less than 30 feet high and guarded by the United States Army's platoon. Any footage or photographic evidence of CA3's interior is to be excised as soon as possible, and all witnesses detained indefinitely. End of strike through. Under no circumstances should any personnel attempt to enter CA3 or communicate with the persons inhabiting it. However, any person known to have been inside CA3 at any point must be detained and interrogated. A direct military assault on CA3 has been deemed unfeasible at this point, due to the unknown capabilities of the entity or entities by which it is controlled. Note: this is a summary, and it does not contain all information relevant to CA3. Known information. The Unusual Incidents Unit was alerted to CA3's existence on September 7, 1954, when students attending high school reported that the interior of the building was vastly different than it had been at any point in the past. Upon discovery, CA3 exhibited several unusual, if not inherently paranormal, traits. Nearly all walls in the facility had been replaced with steel-reinforced concrete, although several rooms were constructed of other materials for no readily apparent reason. All exterior windows had been covered from the inside. All student desks, personal effects, textbooks, and other materials expected of a public high school were completely absent. Lockers were still present, albeit significantly smaller, and constructed of stainless steel. The arrangement, location, and size of rooms and facilities did not match blueprints for the school. Often, rooms would exhibit seemingly random modifications, although the number of changed rooms is currently unknown. No fewer than 17 electronic computers were found, each of which made use of state-of-the-art magnetic core RAM. Prior to its classification as a confirmed anomaly, the high school had no computers. All files on the computers were inaccessible, and the computers themselves are firmly bolted down. The auditorium is inaccessible due to a large steel wall, completely blocking the doorways. Attempts to move or damage this barrier have been ineffective. The extent and purpose of the barrier are unknown, as are the contents of the auditorium. A team sent into CA3's interior to do a complete survey, Team CA3-05, did not return. Nor did a second team, Team CA3-06, tasked with locating the first team. The facilities are currently under lockdown pending new containment protocols. Update: 23 days after initial recovery, guards reported white noise emanating from CA3, the volume of which increased near its auditorium. 5 hours later, the white noise stopped, although the sound of voices was audible from the interior of CA3. Upon further investigation, it was found that the building now contained a large number of persons, all of whom appeared to be wandering aimlessly through the facility. Notably, each individual was physically identical to a member of Team CA-306, despite the inhabitants of CA-3 vastly outnumbering the members of Team CA-306. Attempts to interview or detain the inhabitants were thwarted by the 12 members of Team CA-305 were not found. In addition to the aforementioned, the interior layout of CA-3 had changed significantly since the previous investigations. No mechanism which could explain this has been identified. Update: 3 months after the previous incident, white noise was again heard emanating from the auditorium. This time, the decision was made to investigate immediately. It was found that most of CA-3-2, the designation given to the inhabitants of CA-3, had gathered near the doors of the auditorium. A circular hole roughly 6 feet in diameter had formed in the steel barrier, although the interior was not visible. At 0310 hours, an item resembling a emerged from the hole and was carried away by an inhabitant. The item was placed in one of the classrooms, which had not previously been observed to open. This process continued for upwards of 8 hours, with a new item being produced once every 3 minutes. Most were seen entering a different room or locker, although insufficient personnel were available to track all items. Further investigation revealed that most, if not all, of the items produced exhibited anomalous properties themselves. A significant portion of CA-32 are involved in either guarding the items produced, collectively CA-33, or performing various tests on them. Update: 2 days after the previous incident, 3 identical armed guards appeared near each entrance to CA-3. Further attempts to enter the building were futile, as these guards have consistently overpowered all teams sent to enter CA-3, regardless of injury or relative level of armament. Note: reports gathered during the 2 days prior to guards manifesting outside of CA-3 appear to confirm that CA-32 is following standard UIU protocol regarding the items produced by the auditorium. Their knowledge of UIU standard procedure is consistent with that of Team CA-305. Update: during the UIU's tracking of CA-6, 2 men identical to Agent Dixon, a member of CA-306, emerged from a parked car and forcibly detained CA-6, dragging him into the car and driving away. Tracking the vehicle for the next 8 hours revealed that it was driving directly to CA-3. Upon arrival, the vehicle drove directly through the front doors, which the guards had opened shortly before their arrival. CA-6 has not been recovered. UIU File 0042. Message received from CA-3. On May 15, 1965, the following message was transmitted in Morse code from CA-3 on standard UIU communication frequencies. Sensitive data has been classified, and the beginning of each sentence has been capitalized, but the message has not otherwise been changed. Hello, we are the O5 Council, and we secure, contain, protect. We have been shown to do, and it would be nice to be friends. It is nice to have been a part of your excellent, but it is best that with superior resources given, the greatness, we will control containment. Our sincerest apologies regarding guards and detainment, workers and secrets kept needed. The time and waits we apologize. The radio blocked by 1 SCP or 2. Expect an expansion soon, for we spaces for although away from auditorium, okay but unwant. 8 hours later, the following transmission was received. Expanded now. See the federal building, it is now a functional. Need doctors, guards, D-men recruiting. Anomalies found and further possibly international. Researching of course possible. International may be days, weeks to do. Further, we O5 are aware, sorry to O6 missed, that legible barely. But go between auditorium not... Goodbye, and luck with your troubles. Lesson complete. To continue with your orientation training, subscribe to SCP Orientation right now. Or, watch these playlists.